place ahead of 27th place, sorry, I should say, ahead of Fernandez and Fillon.
Rodrigo's becoming just a real master of pulling off team. Sometimes on Friday, sometimes in qualifying. There's another one, 42.1, nearly 2/10 quicker than anyone else so far in this session.
Yeah, we keep our eyes on the timing screens. Plenty of personal best orange helmets, and we've also got the red ones as well. They just resemble black. The R's at the bottom of your timing screen that you can see on the telly there. Look at this huge group of ambitions for time sheet topping laps. But as Massi comes around the final corner, five elbow, that lot's going to get away from him, and especially not going to find any adhesion, as I mentioned, on the metal.
Team Asia Junior team, you can see that Darren Binder, I mean, yeah, traffic will certainly be holding them up at this late stage. I don't think he'll be on for first place. Indeed he does. He's got a couple of quick guys up ahead of him, including Gabriel Rodrigo, the quickest man so far. What about a cost that he is now looking in a quite precarious position, 17th for the Champions League at the moment.
He knows it's a last lap opportunity. Batch to Pasquier has also been put aside by Rodrigo as well, down into turn 6.
Now he's just jumped up the order as well, at fourth position for the Italian, and he has got a red crash helmet. At fourth position for the Italian, and he has got a red crash helmet through the first sector, looking good for the number 23, like what we saw in Qatar here in Le Mans, the second fastest time, but he couldn't quite get the number one spot. That was Gabriel Rodrigo, fastest again in Moto 3 FP2.
Fenati, Yamanaka, and Stefano Nepa fill out the top 9. Sasaki made it into the top 14, as did Pasquier, McPhee, Rossi and Garcia. So could they be the riders directly through to Q2 tomorrow afternoon? Eyes on the skies tomorrow morning, see.